In this video, we're continuing on with angle bisectors of triangles worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. You can find this free worksheet within the geometry section, and I'll leave a link in the description below. Remember, if you pick a point along an angle bisector, it is the same distance from the one side that it bisects to the other side that it bisects. In number 9, we're finding FT if PT equals 5 and FP equals 7. So we're given PT, this segment here, is 5. FP, this segment, is 7, and we're looking for this segment, FT. We have two sides of a right triangle, since this angle is equal to 90 degrees, because 90 plus 90 is 180, which is a straight line. So since we have two sides of a right triangle, we can use the Pythagorean theorem to solve for the other side. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. A and B are the legs of a triangle, and C is the hypotenuse. So one leg, let's make that B squared, is FT. The other leg, A, is 5, and C, the hypotenuse, is 7. So we have 5 squared plus FT squared, and that's equal to 7 squared. 5 squared is 25, plus FT squared is equal to 7 squared, which is 49. When I subtract 25 from both sides, I'll get that FT squared is equal to 49 minus 25, which is 24. Now I need to take the square root of both sides in order to isolate that FT. So FT equals the square root of 24, and the square root of 24 is 4.898, which rounds to 4.9. So FT equals 4.9 for number 9. In number 10, we're given that PT equals 3, CP equals 8, and we have to find CT. So we're looking for CT, knowing that PT is 3 and is 8. So we're given the hypotenuse of 8, a side of 3, and we're looking for the other unknown leg. So CT squared plus B squared, so CT can be A in this case, plus 3 squared equals our hypotenuse squared, which is 8 squared. So CT squared plus 3 squared, which is 9, equals 8 squared, which is 64. When I subtract 9 from both sides, I'll get that CT squared equals 64 minus 9, which is 55. Then all I have to do is take the square root of both sides to get that CT is equal to the square root of 55, which is 7.416, which rounds to 7.42. So CT is 7.42 in number 10. In number 11, I am to find PB if UC equals 2 and UP equals 3. I know that PB is congruent to PD and PC, since P is the point where all angle bisectors intersect, therefore it is equidistant from each side of the triangle. So the side PC is equal to PB. So PC equals PB. And PC, notice, is a leg of one of the right triangles. And I know the other two sides, so I'll use the Pythagorean theorem to solve for PC. So PC, one of the sides, squared, plus the other side squared, 2 squared, equals C squared, or the hypotenuse squared, which is 3 squared. So PC squared plus 2 squared, which is 4, equals 3 squared, which is 9. So when I subtract 4 from both sides, I get that PC squared equals 5. Now in order to solve for PC, I'll take the square root of both sides to get that PC is equal to the square root of 5, which is 2.24. Now since PC equals 2.24 and PC equals PB, I can say that 2.24 equals PB. So 2.24 is my solution in number 11. So here is 2.24 and PB is also 2.24. And number 12, I need to find XS, this segment here, given that PS is 3 and XP is 5. So I'm given two sides of a triangle and I need to solve for that third side. That third side happens to be a leg. So I'm going to have XS squared plus the other leg squared, which is 3 squared, equals my hypotenuse squared, which is directly across from that right angle, 5 squared. So XS squared plus 9 equals 5 squared, which is 25. When I subtract both sides by 9, I get that XS squared equals 25 minus 9, which is 16. And 16 is a perfect square, so when I take the square root of 16, I'll get that XS is equal to 4. So 4 is my answer in number 12. For numbers 13 through 16, it says each figure shows a triangle with one of its angle bisectors. And number 13, we're finding X if the measure of angle 2 is 4X plus 5, and the measure of angle 1 is 5X minus 2. So 2 is 4X plus 5, and 1 is 5X minus 2. However, since PX is an angle bisector, we know that the measure of angle 2 is equal to the measure of angle 1. And the X we're solving for is not this angle X, but the variable X, which is in each of our equations. So since the measure of angle 2 is congruent to the measure of angle 1, the measure of angle 2 is going to be equal to the measure of angle 1. So 4X plus 5, the measure of angle 2, equals 5X minus 2, the measure of angle 1. So now I'm going to move 4X to the right. 4X minus 4X is 0, so I'll get 5 equal to 5X minus 4X, which is 1X, or simply X, minus 2. Then I'll add 2 to both sides to isolate the X. 5 plus 2 is 7, so 7 is equal to X in number 13. In number 14, it says to find X if the measure of angle 2 equals 1 plus 28X, and the measure of angle XVW, so this angle, is 59X minus 1. Well, we know that the measure of angle 2 is congruent to the measure of angle 1. So since the measure of angle 2 equals the measure of angle 1, that means that 1 plus 28x equals the measure of angle 1, given that the measure of angle 2 is 1 plus 28x. The measure of angle XVW, we can see, is the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2. So the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2 equals the measure of angle XVW. So I'm just going to plug in everything I know. The measure of angle 1 is 1 plus 28x. And I'm going to add that to the measure of angle 2, which is also 1 plus 28x. And that's going to be equal to the measure of angle XVW, which is 59x minus 1. Now I'm going to combine like terms on my left-hand side. 28x gets combined with 28x, and 1 gets combined with 1. 1 plus 1 is 2, so I have 2 plus 28x plus 28x is 56x, and that's equal to 59x minus 1. Next, I'm going to subtract 56x from both sides. So my 56x will cancel out on the left. So since I'm moving my terms with x to the right, I'm going to move my terms without x to the left, and that's adding 1 to each side. So my terms with x are on my right, and my terms without x are on my left-hand side of the equation. 2 plus 1 equals 3. 3 equals 59x minus 56x, which is 3x. And when I divide by 3, I'll get that 1 is equal to x, since 3 divided by 3 is 1, and 3 divided by 3 is 1, times x is x. So 1 equals x in number 14. In number 15, I'm finding the measure of angle 1. So my answer is going to be in degrees. I know that the measure of angle 1 is going to be congruent to the measure of angle 2, since TP is an angle bisector of VTU. So the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2 equals the measure of angle VTU. I'm given that the measure of angle 1 is 7x plus 7. So since the measure of angle 1 equals the measure of angle 2, I'll plug in 7x plus 7 for each of those in this equation. 7x plus 7 plus 7x plus 7 equals the measure of angle VTU, which is 16x plus 4. Combining like terms, 7x with 7x and 7 with 7, I'll get 14x plus 14 equals 16x plus 4. I'll subtract 16x from both sides, moving my terms with x to the left, and I'll subtract 14, moving my terms without x to the right. 14x minus 16x is negative 2x, and that's equal to 4 minus 14, which is negative 10. When I divide by negative 2, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 5. So knowing that x is 5, I'm going to take that value of 5 and plug it into my equation for the measure of angle 1, since I'm solving for the measure of angle 1. So the measure of angle 1 equals 7x plus 7, which equals 7 times x, which is 5, plus 7, which equals 7 times 5 is 35. And when I add 7 to 35, I'll get 42 degrees. So the measure of angle 1 equals 42 degrees in number 15. And lastly on this worksheet, number 16. However, before I go over the answer to this, go ahead, click that subscribe button, and give me a thumbs up while you're at it. So now that you've done that, let's get on with number 16. We're finding the measure of angle 2 if the measure of angle 2 equals 7x plus 5, and the measure of angle 1 equals 9x minus 5. We know that since BP is a bisector, angle 1 is going to be congruent to angle 2. So if the measure of angle 1 equals the measure of angle 2, we'll have that 9x minus 5 equals 7x plus 5. So I'm going to subtract 7x from both sides, moving my terms with x to the left, and I'm going to add 5 to both sides, moving my terms without x to the right. 9x minus 7x is 2x, and that's equal to 5 plus 5, which is 10. When I divide by 2, I'll get that x is equal to 5. However, we're not solving necessarily for x, we're solving for the measure of angle 2. So we're going to plug 5 in for x in that equation. So the measure of angle 2 equals 7x plus 5. 7 times x will be 7 times 5, and we're adding 5 to that. So that's going to be 35 plus 5, which gives us a positive 40. So 40 degrees is the final solution for this worksheet. If you haven't already, click that subscribe button and leave a comment below if you need further clarification or if you found this video useful. And don't forget to click that like button.